on America's sports leader, NBC.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Rick Capcella. Coming up in the first 11 minutes of KARE 11 News, authorities gather evidence and chase leads in the search for the Olympic bomber. We'll have the latest. A Minnesota couple in Centennial Park the night of the blast tells their terrifying story. And new evidence points to a bomb as the cause of the deadly TWA crash. KARE 11 News is next.
Eat 'em up. Hungry?
Why wait? And to really stop hunger cold, try a Snickers ice cream bar.
$6.99 for a complete meal?
Yeah, $6.99.
Great.
Drop the drink.
Want a complete meal that includes desserts and beverages? Old Country Buffet has what you want, all for one low price.
You dropped your beverage.
Old Country Buffet, we're real close to home.
Belinda Jensen on KARE 11 News.
When my first thought was that if there was fireworks or something with the show, that something drastically went wrong.
A Minnesota couple recounts the terrifying moments when a deadly bomb explosion shook Atlanta's Olympic Park. Good evening, everyone. Authorities tonight are expressing confidence they'll catch the person or persons responsible for that bombing. Investigators have thoroughly combed the blast area for evidence, gathering bags full of debris from the bomb. FBI and ATF forensics experts will use the fragments to create a list of leads for investigators to follow. But the threat of another bombing that has authorities now taking no chances. Today, a police bomb squad blew up another suspicious package, this one found near an Atlanta hospital. Police say they've checked out at least a dozen such suspicious packages just today. For one Minnesota couple, a trip to the Olympics was the dream of a lifetime. But as KARE 11's Carolyn Mungo shows us, that dream turned to grim reality yesterday when the bomb went off and they were there.
Millions became connected to the horror in Centennial Park through a television screen. Watching the drama play out in our living rooms was tough enough. But for KARE and Jennifer Swenson, it was different.
It was like a sonic boom. You felt it in your chest.
The Swensons from Monticello were 30 yards from the explosion. They remember now seeing what they would later realize is the law enforcement's attempt to evacuate before it hit.
We were sitting there, and I seen this young kid run across to the left side of us, and then within 30 seconds, there's like six police officers that came running back. So we seen the police officers go in that area, and we just thought it was some people being out of control, and they're going to usher them out.
That's when they heard the explosion.
What?
They rushed with thousands of others to safety. For the Swensons, safety was their hotel 8 blocks away. They spent the next hour peering out their 50th floor window.
We saw the police mounted on horses. The dogs came out. Two military helicopters just circling with searchlights, which was real scary because we were so far up.
It was their last night in Atlanta. The incident couldn't help but cloud an otherwise exciting 5 days at the Olympic Games.
Just terrorized that you're not really safe anywhere.
Carolyn Mungo, KARE 11.
The Swensons' three children stayed home in Minnesota with relatives. They could not wait to get a telephone to tell the family they were safe. We'll have more on plans to reopen Centennial Park coming up a little later in the broadcast. Federal investigators have discovered what could be a key piece of evidence in the investigation of the TWA explosion. Divers found the front part of the plane about a mile from the fuselage. Sources close to the investigation say that indicates a bomb went off in the cargo area, blowing off the front of the aircraft. NTSB officials will not confirm that, but say the fact that the front came off first could be a big clue as to what happened.
I think soon. I think within the next 48 hours we'll get something that we think is going to give us the clues that we need.
Divers are being asked to look for a piece of the jet's aluminum skin. Searchers will soon be getting more help. A specialized naval ship is expected tomorrow to help in the recovery effort. 77 bodies are still unaccounted for. A gas leak in Minneapolis tonight prompted authorities to evacuate several homes. It happened at a Taco Bell on East Lake Street. Authorities say someone tampered with gas line connectors behind the restaurant. The restaurant was closed and several nearby homes evacuated for about a half hour until the leak was contained. Authorities say it was not a serious threat since the gas was dissipating into the air. The city of Minneapolis could log another homicide if the death of an elderly man is ruled a murder. Detectives were called to Vincent Avenue North yesterday after neighbors saw a man's body in the backyard. The victim is a 91-year-old man who lived in the neighborhood more than 40 years. An autopsy reveals he died of blunt force head injuries, but police are not sure yet if he was beaten or suffered the injuries in a fall. By this time tomorrow, the proposed sale of U of M hospitals to Fairview Health System could be a done deal. The U of M's Board of Regents is expected to approve the plan tomorrow. It calls for Fairview to pay the university $87 million and assume debts of $64.5 million. The city of Minneapolis is scrapping a proposal for a door-to-door check of pest licensing compliance. Instead, the city will mount a public information campaign on the issue. The city council also voted to increase the animal control budget. And Minnesota Army reservists who left for duty in Bosnia last December are back in the USA. Members of the two reserve units will spend the next couple weeks at Fort Dix in New Jersey for processing before returning to Minnesota. A Minnesota family is asking for help tonight after a murder-suicide left three young boys orphaned. It happened June 8th outside Mora, Minnesota. Authorities say 40-year-old Greg Corte shot and killed his estranged wife Barbara and her friend, then turned the gun on himself. The couple left behind three sons, ages 8, 10, and 13. Family and friends held a fundraiser for the boys this afternoon.
It's going to be a long road, a hard road for them, but just hope that they know how much we all love them, because we all do, and they can see how much everybody's, you know, doing this so much for them, you know, because that they think they're special, you know, and we all think.
If you'd like to make a donation, a fund is set up for the boys under the name Barbara Corte at the Cherokee State Bank in West St. Paul. Well, it looks like our run of nice weather is going to continue for a while. For more on that, we're going on out to the backyard where Belinda Jensen's standing by. Good news.
Yes, good news. Good morning almost, too. We have some really nice weather coming up this evening. We've had some very strong thunderstorms in the Dakotas. These are all drifting off to the southeast. So in the morning hours, we'll probably have the clouds from these showers over the Twin Cities. But I think the best chance of showers tomorrow will be in the afternoon hours. There'll be a 30% chance of returning thunderstorms, redeveloping thunderstorms over the Twin Cities. Once those thunderstorms move off, though, the rest of the week looks high and dry. Temperatures warming up toward 80 by Friday. We're going to start out in the middle 70s at the beginning of this week. Here's the forecast for tomorrow. Partly cloudy in the morning, and then the best chance of showers will be in the afternoon. The daytime high will be 76. And in about 10 minutes, I'll let you know about the rest of the forecast. It looks really good for the rest of the week, Rick.
All right, Belle, thanks a lot. We'll hook up with you a bit later. And now for our first look at sports. We want to check in with Tim McNiff down in Atlanta. Tim.
Well, thanks, Rick. After a one-game absence, the Minnesota Twins have climbed back into the win column. And right-hander Rick Aguilera has won back-to-back starts for the first time in the last 9 years, although neither feat came easy. We'll pick it up in the fifth inning of today's game against Boston. Twins up 4-3 when Pat Mears singles to right, scoring Scott Stachowiak and Roberto Kelly, and it's 6-3 Twins. Now, Twins up 9-4 in the ninth. Eddie Gordado facing Archimedes Pozo with the bases loaded, nobody out. Pow! Pozo, who won last night's game with a ninth-inning triple, has the Sox within a run at 9-8 after the slam. And Tom Kelly says, bring in Dan Nolte. Nolte facing Kevin Mitchell with two outs, and Mitchell's fly to Cordova will be the game's final out. The Twins hang on to win it 9-8. They've won six of their last seven, and Baltimore is in for the first of three on Tuesday night. And there's trouble in paradise. Chicago Bulls forward Dennis Rodman has told the Chicago Sun-Times that he'd rather quit than play for a paltry $6 million a season. Rodman calls the Bulls' latest offer an insult and says he's worth at least $11 million a year after leading the NBA in rebounding each of the last five seasons. Well, Rick, because that story reminds me so much of your last contract negotiations, I'll send it back to you in the cities.
Not exactly sure how to read that, but okay, thanks, Tim. A sad note tonight out of the Minnesota Zoo, where one of two baby dolphins born this summer has died. Despite the loss, the zoo went ahead with its Zoo Fest 96 today, featuring the surviving dolphin calf. Zoo officials say dolphins face a perilous first year of life in the wild or in human care. Up to half do not survive to 1 year of age. Well, when we come back, we've got more gold medal Olympic coverage for you, like how one Olympian's heart went out to a victim of the bombing and what he did about it. And you'll meet a Minnesotan who is the last line of defense for the U.S. women's soccer team.
This is it, gentlemen. Finds like these turn careers into legends.
It is a legend. I mean, it's responsible for the entire species.
I can't believe it's in this kind of shape after so many years.
All right, let's get it out of here.
Get the crate!
Wait! They left the keys in it!
The legendary Jeep Cherokee Sport. With a lease rate of just $219 a month, it could be exactly what you've been searching for.
See your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
Hi, I'm George Corporal. When you need auto glass replaced, give us a call. You can use the time you save to enjoy that free box of Simic steaks we give you. That guy's worth listening to.
Put yourself in this picture. Call Glass Service Company today.
As a delivery company, our business revolves around addresses. Your address, the address you're shipping to, millions of addresses worldwide. You give us an address, you get it there. But today, we're giving you an address. Welcome to UPS on the Internet. From here, you can arrange pickups, check rates, even track packages, all from your own computer, anywhere in the world. Whether you're at an address or not, UPS, moving at the speed of business.
There are only a select few who know what it's like to go for the gold. And now, KARE 11 News has caught up with these unique Minnesotans to hear their stories of courage. Hear their summer reflections, only on KARE 11 News.
If you've been looking for one truck that is tough and a smart buy, the 96 F-150 is the one truck to look at. And right now, with 600 cash back, lease one for just $199 a month. Get a tough, regular cab F-150 now, because your Northland Ford dealer's closing out the last of the 96s. A great selection equipped the way you want for just $199 a month. One truck to look at, one time to get it, and one place to go. Your Northland Ford dealer.
The Olympic spirit is seen in many ways. Today was shown by U.S. wrestler Matt Ghaffari. The silver medalist made a trip to the hospital to visit with bombing victim Fallon Hawthorne. Her mother died in the blast. Ghaffari let the teenager wear his Olympic medal and invited her to be his guest at an Olympic event when she is released from the hospital. Well, that bombing has gotten a lot of attention. The games themselves continue to be the main attraction. For more on that, we're going to go live now to Joan Steffen and Randy Shaver, hanging out in Atlanta. How are you guys?
Oh, doing all right, Rick.
Yeah, things are getting back to normal, I would say, closer to normal here in Atlanta. Although the investigation into that bombing does continue, and we hope that the FBI will be releasing a composite sketch of the suspect in the next couple of days. We look forward to that, and we do understand now that the park, Centennial Park, is going to reopen. It's going to be a day later than they had anticipated. They had earlier said it would open on Monday. Now it's going to open on Tuesday morning. And some of the ideas they've got as far as increasing the security there, they plan to double law enforcement presence in the park. They're going to add observation points. They're going to use new security technology, although they didn't elaborate on exactly what they would be adding there. They are going to conduct random bag checks in the area, and they are asking the public for help. They want the public to alert them to anything unusual in the park that they see, and they're going to be checking on that. Obviously, things are never going to get back to quite the way they were before, but they do hope that people will come back to the park.
From the standpoint of the experience they have in the park, the enthusiasm, the enchantment, the excitement, the sense of celebration, the fun, the remarkable experience, the picture taking and so forth, I expect it not only to be as good as it was, but probably better.
That remains to be seen. It does open on Tuesday.
Well, we had tickets to team handball today. What did you think?
You know, I had a great time. I really enjoy the sport. It would have been a lot more fun had they won, but it was a blast.
We're talking about the USA women's handball team. They played their second game today, a game that they had to win in order to make it to the medal round or have a chance to do that. We all had tickets to it and enjoyed the game a lot. Unfortunately, as Joan said, and we'll show you the final score, they played against Hungary today, and Team USA, with five Minnesotans on the team, lose today. The final was 30-24. And after the game, I talked with very disheartened and very emotional team members, Laura Coonan and Carol Paterka.
You've represented this country three times now, and I know it's been disappointing all three times, but You certainly have a lot to be proud of.
Yeah, maybe in a couple weeks I'll think that, but, you know, it's just really so disappointing right now that, like you just said, we've been to the Olympics, we know what it's about, and we've been there, done that, and it was our time to win, and it was our last chance to win, and we didn't, so, and, you know, when we tell stories to our grandkids and stuff, it'll be the good things, it won't be those.
Can you put into words what today means and how you feel about it?
I guess just sometimes you just go out there and try so hard, and, you know, you try as hard as you can, and it just doesn't go your way. You know, I guess all you could do is just, you know, just work hard, and it just was one of those days that it just didn't happen.
You know, night after night, we see all the winners on NBC, but it's the losers that hurt the most.
Well, it took a lot for them to come out and talk to us, and we do appreciate that. The U.S. women's soccer team is right where they want to be. After 9 minutes of overtime today, American Shannon McMillan put in the winning goal against Norway. The final there is 2-1, and that, of course, means that the USA is in the gold medal round against China on Thursday. Now, in goal for the USA is Minnesota's Bryce Curry, a determined athlete out of Anoka High School.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.
I was the only girl on the team the first year I played, so they stuck me in the goal thinking it'd be safe, and I've been in the goal for about 10 years now. I think I like the idea of being able to win the game by myself. I mean, if I can prevent the other team from scoring, I can prevent them from winning.
Brianna Scurry is the starting goalkeeper for the first ever U.S. Women's Olympic soccer team, a team that's favored to win a gold medal.
It's a good group, and we're unbelievable athletes, and we're out here to win for ourselves and each other, and that's the key, and that's the thing we have over other teams, I think. Okay, all the ones that I saw out the window are gone. Gone!
It's genuine camaraderie both on and off the field.
I got skunked.
And it's no wonder Brianna is one of the leaders.
But I think I bring a stability to the defense on this team. When I have the ball in my hands, I think the team feels very comfortable with me back there.
Brianna began her elite track as a high school All-American at Anoka. She went on to become the National Collegiate Goalkeeper of the Year, but the 96 Olympic Games just may be her destiny.
Yeah, that was a good time, Bri.
I've wanted to be on the Olympic team of some sport since I was like 8 years old. And this is a great thing for me that we have an opportunity to win a gold medal, because I wanna do this well for my parents and for myself and my family.
Yeah, they play for that on Thursday. Should be very exciting. Mm-hmm. A couple of very exciting moments in the track and field tonight as we close out our segment from Atlanta, starting with a gold medal in the high jump for men, Team USA, for the first time since 1968, since Fosbury created the Fosbury flop. Charles Austin tonight, 7 feet, 10 1/4 inch to win the gold medal in the high jump competition. Obviously a very exciting night for him. And in the long jump tonight, Carl Lewis on his last attempt. He was 15th heading into this jump, but 9 inches short of the board, he still goes 27 feet 2 1/2 to qualify for the finals in the long jump. And of course, Carl Lewis, the perennial long jump and 100-meter champion with 8 gold medals total.
Going for 4 in a row. Hope he can do it. That'll do it for us, and we'll see you back here tomorrow.
Hey, guys, that cloud of the whole bombing issue, has that pretty much passed now? Do you feel like it's beyond that? Just in terms of the atmosphere down there, what are you dealing with?
I think it's a lot different than yesterday.
I think making progress, but I wouldn't say maybe passed. I think that it's going to be in the back of everybody's mind for quite a while.
Certainly different than yesterday's
atmosphere.
Yeah.
All right, well, we'll be talking to you more. Thanks.
Okay. All right.
Coming up in sports, we're going to head back down to Atlanta with Tim McNiff, who has some news about Daryl Strawberry. And we'll show you a rookie who's getting a second look from the Vikings.
Those who own the finest the world has to offer expect a lot from their cars. Impeccable service, precise engineering, flawless in every detail. So it is telling that 2/3 of LS400 owners purchase another Lexus. With the highest customer loyalty in its class, the LS400 offers a custom fit in an off-the-rack world. Unthinkable, except by Lexus of Wayzata.
This is big news. This is unbelievable. gotta let everybody know.
Join friends and family free and get 1 free hour of calls automatically every month to other MCI customers. No names, no lists, free calls every month. There's no better savings than free, honey. Call now to sign up for this new plan, friends and family free. Free calls, whoopee!
Buy a high-efficiency central air conditioner, and NSP has a surprise for you. A rebate of up to $300 and lower summer energy bills.
Mr. and Mrs. Compton?
Yes?
Your rebate check!
It's here!
You can get a rebate, too. Air conditioners with efficiency ratings of 12 or more qualify.
Could we close the door now? We're trying to conserve energy, you know.
Oh. Wise move.
Right now, back to Atlanta, the sports, and Tim McNiff standing by. How are you, Tim?
I'm okay, Rick. I'm somewhat frustrated, though. You don't know how tough it is to be here in Atlanta at the Olympic Games when you know the Vikings are in training camp in Mankato. Now, the sad part is I'm actually somewhat sincere when I say that, but I'm not the only one who's missing from Mankato. In what's becoming somewhat of a Viking tradition, Robert Smith, the running back, is once again a training camp holdout. And that means more reps for rookie Mo Williams. Now, the Vikes took Williams out of Kentucky in the third round of last April's draft rather than go for back Chris Darkins. And after 1 week of camp, the Vikes are looking forward to seeing more of Mo.
Mo looks good. I'm pleased. I think, you know, any of you watch Mo, Mo has excellent hands, very slashing style. All the backs look good. You know, very dependable. Scotty Graham was running for a lot of yardage for us in the last few years is there. But Mo Williams looks good. He has excellent hands, catches the ball well, and has a very effective slashing style.
That said, let's get Robert Smith signed and in camp as soon as possible. Hey, it's nice to be talking about football when the Twins are actually still in contention for a playoff spot. The Twins return to the win column this afternoon. They take 3 of 4 from the Red Sox in the process. We're going to pick this one up in the eighth inning. Twins up 7-4. Jeff Rebele singles to right center, scoring Marty Cordova and Scott Stachowiak. And it's 9-4 Twins on top. A ninth-inning grand slam by Archimedes Pozo had the Sox within a run, but Dan Nolte comes in to shut the door, and the Twins hang on to a 9-8 win, taking 3 of 4 from Boston. The Twins open up a 3-game set against the Orioles Tuesday night at the Dome. And finally, to the Big Apple in New York, Yankees and Royals, and with the Yanks down 2-1 in the bottom of the ninth, pow! Daryl Strawberry belts his 300th career home run. It's a 2-run shot and propels the Yanks to a 3-2 come-from-behind win over KC and continues Straw's comeback story. Now, Rick, I really want you to go to the office and complain about that $6 million you're earning. Just like Dennis Rodman, you're worth at least $11
million. Well, I really appreciate it. And I want you to know, Tim, it means a lot to me that you stayed with me tonight.
I'm with you all the time. You know that.
All right. Thanks, Tim. Coming up, when we come back, Belinda Jensen and the weekend weather.
Some kids are born with a peculiar passion for the weather.
Kenny!
Ken? A few eventually will develop a genius for meteorology. This genius is not always followed by the sense to come in out of the rain. We've grown to care. Ken Barlow and KARE 11 News.
As a proud sponsor of the 1996 U.S. Olympic team, Chevrolet wants to salute America's athletes and all the other hardworking everyday athletes in the heartland. To do that, your local Chevrolet Geo dealers are offering the Chevy Lumina, starting at just $17,095, or the Chevy Cavalier, starting at just $11,210. Chevrolet, cars more Americans trust for some of the hardest working everyday athletes around. Lease or buy one today at your heartland Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Remember, recession, jobs lost. The Dole GOP bill tries to deny nearly a million families unemployment benefits. Higher interest rates, 10 million unemployed. With a Dole amendment, Republicans try to block more job training. Today, we make more autos than Japan. Record construction jobs, mortgage rates down, 10 million new jobs, more women-owned companies than ever. The president's plan. Education, job training, economic growth for a better future.
Why does this always happen right before a presentation?
I can't even believe this.
Tell you what, boys, these computers are really slow.
When the network isn't working...
What? I never stopped responding.
Neither are you.
I've tried that already. Okay.
We make networks work. We're Enterprise Networking Services from U.S. West.
You are watching KARE 11.
Belinda Jensen joins us now out in the backyard with a sign of what's coming in the week ahead. It's looking pretty sweet.
Can you just have him just keep that music going? Because that'll keep me awake.
Is that what you need?
Yeah, that's what I need.
You're going to be good. Jamming to the weather
just
out there.
Just keep it right there. That's great. Let's take a look at the almanac for this 28th of July. It was a nice day overall. You know, we had a lot of clouds this morning, but everything cleared out. We had a nice evening. 76 was the high. A little cooler than normal. A little cooler than normal. It should have been 83 today for the daytime high. Trace of rain. As we take a look at the country, what's been going on for the last couple of weeks and what's going to continue going on around the country is a big dome of high pressure in the west and a trough of low pressure in the east. That's why there's been real cool temperatures in the east and the really warm temperatures in the west. Atlanta had rain showers this morning, but then it cleared up. And most of the afternoon was clear, but as we head up into the upper Mississippi Valley, really strong thunderstorms went through Chicago. Also, there's been a flash flood watch out all day in Las Vegas and rain showers in Southern California. That's very abnormal for the late July months, and it looks as though late July weeks anyway, and into early August, they normally don't have very much rain at all. Around the upper Midwest, we have a line of thunderstorms that's been blossoming all night long, some very strong thunderstorms. Those are all coasting off to the southeast, and they are going to continue to coast off in that direction and die out. The clouds will be over the Twin Cities when you wake up tomorrow morning, though. But this is what should happen. We will have thunderstorms redeveloping tomorrow afternoon, and then after they move out tomorrow afternoon into early Tuesday morning, then the rest of the week looks really dry. Tonight, we have the partly cloudy skies, and then tomorrow, high pressure starting to move in, and we'll have a little bit of sunshine peeking out probably around 10 to around noon, and then the thunderstorms will redevelop. In fact, there'll be about a 30% chance of those. Stronger thunderstorms are expected up to the north as this little trough moves through. There might be a lingering shower on Tuesday morning, and then high pressure is going to move in for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and the temperatures will warm close to 80. Here's your forecast for the Twin Cities in detail with the music. Partly to mostly cloudy skies tonight and dropping off to around 59 degrees. Tomorrow, we will, like I said, have the partly cloudy skies in the morning, and then in the afternoon, those thunderstorms redeveloping. The daytime high tomorrow, much like today, 76 degrees with east winds as that storm moves in. Tuesday morning, this is going to be early morning showers. Most of the day on Tuesday will be dry and 75 degrees. And then, as I said, we start warming up. 77 on Wednesday, 78 on Thursday. The Lake Country tonight, some clouds. Tomorrow, some rain showers. And Tuesday, some sunshine and 76 degrees. That's all I have from out here.
You know, Belle, you're the only person I know who can stay pumped up with Muzak.
That's right.
All right. Bye. Still ahead, talking child's play. We're taking it to new heights. First, tonight's winning lottery numbers. They are the Daily 3, 610.
It took sparks of imagination, technology, and engineering to build the car that would best the Honda Accord. The result? Chrysler Cirrus. With a higher resale value, more standard features like air and ABS, and more passenger and cargo space. When you set a new standard, you expect a reaction. And priced thousands less than a comparably equipped Accord, Chrysler Cirrus is sure to get one.
It's like my dad going through this phase.
Hey, there really are four parts to a plumbing system.
He found Q&A in the redesigned U.S. West Direct Yellow Pages. With a phone call, Dad can find, you know, whatever.
Black transmission fluid spells trouble.
Q&A's got hundreds of free recorded messages. Q&A is really cool, but in some hands,
Hey, hon! Acne's caused by overactive glands!
It can be a dangerous thing.
No wonder it's the one that gets used. U.S. West Direct.
It starts here. And it starts here. And it even starts here. Because it all starts here at Walmart, home of the EverStart battery. A powerful new battery that you can count on to start when you need it to. And since it's at Walmart, you can also count on a good price. EverStart, the name says it all.
Before we go tonight, we've all heard about the mansions in Bel Air. Well, now they're building castles there. Well, sandcastles, anyway. There's a world sandcastle building competition underway in California right now. Both professionals and amateurs are sculpting their masterpieces. Rules stipulate no supports are allowed, only water and sand. But after hours of labor building them, the works of art don't last long. After the competition, kids race to the castles and delight in tearing them down. It's really something else, isn't it, Val?
It's great.
You just got here in time. All right. That's all we have time for. We'll see you later.
Bye.
I want to buy a quality piece of unfinished furniture, and I want a huge selection to choose from. Woody's Unfinished Furniture in St. Louis Park has the largest on-site selection of unfinished furniture in the Twin Cities. Call 929-6300.
Auto glass replacement by Glass Service Company. We give you time for the more important things in life. Hi, I'm George Corporal. We have excellent installers and quality glass. We even bill your insurance company directly. When you need auto glass replaced, give us a call.
Years ago, he won gold, then fell into a depression so deep he quit the sport. Tonight, diver Mark Lenzi looks to soar again.
It's a battle between one man and the torrents of water as American whitewater ace Scott Shipley takes on the Ocoee River.
The golden dreams of Tara Cross Battle and the U.S. women's volleyball team are in jeopardy. To dream on, they must win tonight as the Centennial Olympic Games continue.